So here in Final Cut Pro 10, I want to share some of the shortcuts that I use daily to move around the timeline. Now, if you can move around the timeline, make selections in the timeline, and modify clips in the timeline quickly, then you can really improve the speed at which you're editing. So I'm going to run through a few of those tips here. So the first thing to have a look at is how we play our timeline. So the shortcuts I use on the keyboard are the J, K, and L keys. And the L key will play, so it will do the same job as the spacebar. And the J key will play backwards or rewind your clip. And the K key will pause your clip. Or if you hold down the K in conjunction with J and L, it allows you to tap forwards or backwards one frame at a time. So let's have a look at how this works. So if I tap L, I'm going to play forward in my clip. If I press the J key, I'm going to move backwards in my edit. So I'm pressing K to pause as I'm moving between these two keys, the J and the L key. And then if I double tap L, it's not going to show really on the time lapse there, but basically now I'm fast forwarding through my footage. So you can see my seconds are moving at double speed. So if I tap either J or L, I can fast forward or rewind at different rates. So if I press the J key a few times here now, so 1, 2, 3, you can see I'm quickly moving back through my edit there. Now, if we hold down the K key, we can do a couple of things here. So one is if I tap L or J, I'm going to move forwards and backwards one frame at a time. We'll just find a clip where this is going to show up a little bit more. So we'll move to the time lapse at the beginning here. So you can see if I hold down K and tap L, I'm moving forwards one frame at a time. So you can see the time code right in the middle of my screen there moving. And if I hold down K and tap J, it's going to move backwards one frame at a time. Now, if I come ahead a couple of clips and I'm moving through my edit points by pressing the apostrophe key, which is just 2 to the right of my L key on the keyboard. So I've got my semicolon and my apostrophe. And if I press the apostrophe here, it's going to move through each of the edit points and even move through these connected clips. That's another really useful shortcut. The semicolon will move you to the previous edit and the apostrophe will move you to the next edit point. Okay, so you can see I'm moving forwards and backwards between the edit points. So with this clip now, if I press play, so I'm pressing L to play forwards. If I now pause this by pressing K, but hold down K and press L again, you can see that I'm slow motioning at 1/3 speed through my clip. So these are really useful ways of moving through a clip. Okay, so if I hold down K again and tap J, it's going to move backwards at 1/3 speed. So those are the keyboard shortcuts that I use a lot of the time. So we're talking about J, K, and L here in different guises, and then also the semicolon and the apostrophe, which is right next to the semicolon. Now, if I press the semicolon here to move back to the previous edit point, the next shortcut that I use quite a lot is the right-hand or left-hand square bracket. So if I press the right-hand square bracket, it's going to select the endpoint on the edit point that I'm on. And if I press the left-hand square bracket, and these are just to the right of the P key on your keyboard. So if I press the left-hand square bracket, it's going to select the out point of the outgoing clip. And then we can flip between those by jumping between the square brackets. So if we have edits that we want to make here, I can press just to the right of the M key, the comma, to edit back by one frame. So I'm changing the out point of that clip. So if I hold down the command key and tap plus just to zoom into my timeline there now, you can see that when I'm tapping the comma key, I'm actually moving that edit point back one frame at a time. And if I press the period just to the right of the comma, then I'm going to move forwards one frame at a time. So I can change the out point, or I can chop the in point here by one frame at a time by pressing the period, or extend it by pressing the comma. So those are a couple of other useful shortcuts that I use when I want to really refine the edit. I'm going to zoom out here a little bit and just press the semicolon to come back to my edit point here. Now, once I've selected the edit point, if I want to play around it to see if it's working, I can hold down shift and tap the question mark, and it's going to play into that edit point. So I can see the edit working, and then it's going to keep playing through that edit point because I've got loop turned on. Now, if you're like me and you have kind of a short-term memory for shortcuts, I move between Photoshop, Illustrator, Final Cut Pro a lot. So I tend to remind myself of some shortcuts when I actually come to do a certain repetitive task. Now, if we want to remind ourselves of those shortcuts, we can go up to the Help menu. And so for things like loop that I just mentioned, we can type into the Help menu, or any menu item, in fact, we can type in that menu item and then hover over the search results here, and it will show us where that menu item is in the menu. So this is really useful for finding any command or function within Final Cut Pro 10 or other applications on the Mac. And when you know there's a function there, but you just can't find it in the different menus. It's a really neat feature on the Mac. So if I click on here again, and for instance, I want to find the shortcut for snapping, I can type snap in, and it's going to show me exactly where that is in the menus down here. So when I hover over it here, we get this nice little floating blue arrow that shows me where that function is. So that's a real neat way of finding those different shortcuts and reminding yourself of where things are. So I just wanted to show you where the loop function was. So if I go to view, playback, then we have this loop playback option, which allows you to loop a section of the clip. So when we use the play around edit, we can loop that playback so we can kind of test the edit. We can modify the edit point as we're looping around. So you can see the play around option is up here and basically allows us to play around that edit point. So when I click it, it's gonna play it. When I pause it, it's gonna jump back to that edit point. Now, if I am playing around that edit point, then I can use the comma and the period to the right of the M key to nudge that edit point as I'm actually playing back. Okay, so you can see I can let it play through. Maybe it's not quite right. I nudge it to the right a little, and then it will come back through that edit point. So I press K again to pause that, and we come back to that edit point where we can make further changes. So the other shortcut I use a huge amount when I'm working on the timeline is Shift and tapping the Z key to zoom me to the entire timeline. And you can use that in a couple different places. If we're zoomed in on clips up here, okay, we can use Command Plus to zoom into our clips here. And we can also use Shift Z to bring us back to the thumbnail view. So in different windows, you can use Command Plus and Minus to zoom in and Shift and Z to zoom out. And what I wanted to do was just bring down one more clip to the timeline here. So I'm just gonna scrub down and we'll grab another clip. So these images are from a trip to Dinosaur Park in Alberta. And this is another shortcut that I use a lot, is the H key for bringing the hand tool up. Hand tool is not gonna destroy anything in your edit. If you've got any other tool selected, such as the selection tool, the shortcut for which is A, then you can move things around. You could accidentally nudge an edit point. But with the hand tool, all we can do is move our edit around. So if you're nervous as you're starting out with Final Cut Pro about modifying your edit when you don't want to, then the hand tool is a good tool to use. So I'm just gonna tap A again to come back to my selection tool. And I'm gonna drop the sound levels here. We don't need that for this. So what I wanna do now is just show you how I cut out different sections from a clip that I'm working on. So using the JK and L key, if I'm editing something like a tutorial or a dialogue, then I'll use J obviously to play backwards. We'll zoom in a little bit here so we can see a bit more movement. L to move forwards. And then as soon as I find a point, so I'm nudging forwards and backwards by holding down K and tapping J or L here, I can find my spot, press the I key, and then play forwards. Find the moment which I want to cut out. Again, hold down K and just nudge to find the right spot. And then when I found the right spot, I'll press the O key to mark an out point. So I and O mark an in and out point on my timeline. I can press backspace and then remove that section. So you can see I've now got an edit point there. I can remove that section from my timeline. So I can press I, play forwards, tap K, press O, and then press the backspace to remove that selection. The other keyboard shortcut, so I just tap the semicolon there to move between those edit points. The other shortcut that I use a lot on the timeline when I'm modifying my timeline is the X key. So I'm on the end point of this clip in the middle here that I've just made by cutting chunks out of that longer clip. If I press X, it's gonna select that entire clip. So basically, if I have my playhead placed anywhere, just deselect that. If I have my playhead placed anywhere within that clip and I press X, it's gonna select that clip. So anywhere from the end point through to the end of the clip, it's gonna select the clip, and then I can press X to select it and backspace to delete it. So those are a few of the shortcuts I use. The most useful by far are the JK and L keys for moving through the timeline, but then I and O are really useful. I'm often editing a lot of dialogue in some of these tutorials I'm making online, so I'm cutting out my ums, ahs, and okays, and so that the tutorials are a bit easier for you guys to listen to. And then when I'm working on projects as well, being able to move between my edit points is really useful. One other shortcut that I'll just mention quickly and lastly, the last one, is that if I have markers on my timeline, and M is the shortcut to add a marker, and if you tap M again, it will allow you to name it. Those markers become searchable as well in the timeline index, but we won't get into that now. But in terms of moving around the timeline, if I hold down Control and tap my semicolon, or my comma, it's going to move me between those points in the timeline. So there's a few really useful shortcuts for moving around your timeline, for speeding up your editing in Final Cut Pro 10. I hope that's useful, and I hope to see you on the next tutorial.